Well, for more on the situation in Syria, I can now talk to Lawrence Freeman from the Executive Intelligence Review magazine, joining us live there in the States. Well, Russia has said that the UN Human Rights Report on Syria doesn't reflect the real situation in the country. What is it that worries Russia and China over the UN stance?
Both Russia and China are correctly worried about what is behind the policy in Syria and also Iran. Unfortunately, President Obama is acting on a British geopolitical plan to force a confrontation with Russia and China, a military confrontation of which Syria and Iran would merely be the ignition point. But the real goal is a war to stop the progress that Russia and China are involved in. And, of course, this could result, and I think the Russians and the Chinese are aware of this, this could result in World War III. So it's extremely dangerous, and measures have to be taken now to stop these policies by President Obama and the British.
Some would say extremely far-reaching views you have there. But let's look at the situation at the moment, where we have the majority of those in the Human Rights Council supporting what has been said about the human rights issue there. What do you think, then, could happen next? In what way would this prompt the next move from the UN Security Council?
Well, I think we can see it very clearly. Look how the situation in Libya was run, which was the point that now ignited and pushed the whole process forward. You had various claims of human rights abuses. So under the Tony Blair doctrine of the responsibility to protect, Obama led a NATO bombing drive illegally, according to the U.S. Constitution, so-called to protect people, so-called out of humanitarian concern. And everybody knew or should have known that this was a policy for regime change. And that's what we're looking at here. And now I think you've seen the recent involvement again of the International Criminal Court, which is a total creation of George Soros. And this court is being used to carry out regime change all over Africa. And this is the danger that people see in Syria. Why have a policy of sanctions and military intervention? Why not have a policy of diplomatic development and encouraging the country to resolve the problems, as I think the Russians and the Chinese realize is the best way forward?
You're talking about regime change there in Syria. Regime change was indeed affected by what the NATO did during the Libyan conflict. Now, the UN Human Rights Chief has actually called for urgent action to protect civilians in Syria. That is reminiscent of what was said in Libya, wasn't it, or about Libya, when that no-fly zone was imposed.
Oh, yeah. Look, those are the key code words. When they start talking about humanitarian concerns, and they really don't care at all about the people. This is the same thing that was done against President Bashir in Sudan. They use the key words, humanitarian concern, and this doctrine of Tony Blair, the responsibility to protect, and says, okay, now we will move in. We will decide with our military capability of NATO, backed up by the U.S., with the British pulling the strings behind the scenes, we will move in and decide what is good for a country. And this is completely opposite of what the real interests of the United States are. And the Russians and the Chinese are seeing this being played out again, and they are beginning to respond, especially the Russians are responding militarily by sending the Kuznetsov aircraft carrier into the Syrian waters. Is a risky game, but the Russians are aware of the danger. If they don't do it, what could happen?
Certainly major implications there you're talking about. It's very interesting to hear your thoughts. Lawrence Freeman from the Executive Intelligence Review magazine, live there in Baltimore in the USA. Thank you for your thoughts.